Welcome to FNC UI Pack version 4.0. This new version comes with many great improvements. Let's have a look at a few of them. First of all, many components have been updated with a modern look and feel without any need for customization. Simply select the component from the tool palette, drop it on the form, and run your application. No further customization is needed, but of course, all the previous customization options are still available. However, all controls look great right from the start. In addition, the already introduced global font properties for other FNC controls will now be introduced to FNC UI Pack. In particular, this release addresses the planner control, the tree view control, the Kanban board, and the grid. For a component pack that offers as much variety as the FNC UI Pack, documentation and accessibility of its documentation is at utmost importance. In addition to the PDF documentation, TMS now offers online documentation so that you can access the documentation anywhere with any device. In addition to look and feel, new features have been added. The planner control now supports all-day appointments, and the tree view is now able to display JSON content. The content can be loaded from files and from streams, and the look and feel of the data is customizable using HTML templates. Let's have a look at the new look and feel of the FNC planner control. Select it on the tool palette, drop it on the form, and right away we have a modern look and feel. Of course, the control is fully interactive at design time as well. We scroll down and we see the appointments that have been added by default. New, you can select appointments to be all day appointments. Let's change the QA appointment to an all day appointment. The items property allows us to edit appointments at design time as well as runtime. Selecting the first item from the list, we can toggle the full day property from false to true, and we see the result right away. The Q&A appointment is now an all-day appointment. I also mentioned on the slides that more and more controls support the global font property. Have a look here. The global font property allows you to specify a font name or simply set the size, the base size of a component. For example, right now, everything is based on the font of the form. So if I want to make it bigger, I simply select a size of 12, and all sizes of all the different properties for the control will be changed accordingly. I can easily change the size to accommodate a variety of users. This way, I can change various size properties by simply changing one property. Internally, TMS will calculate all other font sizes relative to the font size specified in global font. Let's look at the tree view and its new JSON capabilities. Drop the tree view from the tool palette, and right away I notice this is too small for me. I would like it a little bit bigger. So I select the global font property and set the size to 11. Notice that the header stays bold and all the other properties just use the font size but aren't changed to bold fonts. Also, as this is a technical document, I would like to use a monospace font. I change it to JetBrains Mono. So by changing two properties, I get a completely custom look and feel for the control. Rename the control to tree and add the code that is needed to load my JSON. Code completion is very helpful here to show us all the different overloads of the new viewJSON method. I can load JSON from a file name, from a string, or from a stream. Let's just use a file name. I previously downloaded the JSON from the iTunes web service, which shows information about a music album. So I run this, and there we go. A very nice view of the different hierarchies of my JSON document. Note that even Unicode characters are shown correctly. Customization of all the different elements inside of a JSON document is also possible. You can either specify another parameter here using a special class. However, it is much, much easier to change these options at design time in the object inspector. Simply look for default, and then you find the default view JSON options. And there you can specify an array prefix. For example, let's change this to array. I don't want a suffix. You can specify if the nodes should be expanded by default. That's a good default in my opinion. And then here you can specify two HTML templates for the name part of the JSON and for the value part of the JSON. And you can also select which of the columns is supposed to be stretched if you resize the tree view. Let's just change the value to be printed in bold. So I changed the template to bold. Value. Value is the placeholder for the value, and name is the placeholder for the name of the JSON item. After this slight change, the values are printed in bold, and the names are still printed as before. Also note that all the different array items now have the prefix array. The final control I would like to show in this introduction is the updated Kanban board. Dropping the control on the form, you immediately see the differences to the previous versions. It looks great right from the start. And using the global font property, we can easily resize the whole board and make it bigger or smaller. This allows you to offer a setting inside of your application for your end users to easily customize the overall look of your Kanban boards. And again, changing, for example, from the Windows default font to Arial is as easy as changing yet another property. Making your applications accessible for a huge variety of users has become so much easier with the global font property and all the other look and feel improvements of FNC UI Pack. Let me finish with the, in my opinion, most important item on the list. As I learned from LinkedIn today, the number one approach how to debug your application is to read the documentation. And TMS delivers now on all fronts. In addition to the PDF documentation, you now have online documentation at your fingertips, which is suitable on all your devices. It is fully responsive and can be accessed using any web browser. Get a first impression of the component pack using the Getting Started category. And then you can use the reference looking up each and every control, nicely categorized by topics. And for each component, you get the properties, its methods, and its events. And as you use from TMS, dozens of illustrations are used to visualize the topics. Let me just close with an explanation of FNC. FNN stands for Framework Neutral. That means you can use all of the controls that I've just shown you either in the VCL, FireMonkey, or TMS WebCore. Yes, you can use the very same control, the very same class in all these frameworks. That means you can use the same control in FireMonkey that you've gotten used to in the VCL building desktop applications. This makes you more efficient because your learning curve is significantly lower. And this opens up the world of true multi-platform desktop and mobile development. You can develop applications using FNC UI Pack for Microsoft Windows, Apple macOS, Linux, even the Raspberry Pi and the mobile platforms Android and Apple iOS. If you're not a license holder already, go to fnc.tmssoftware.com to download your trial version today.